الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا وربا شاهدا ونحن له مسلمون. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، أرسله بين يدي الساعة بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إليه بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آل بيته الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته الغر المحجلين وعلى التابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم بمن الله وفضله وجوده وكرمه، فهو أكرم الأكرمين أرحم الراحمين رب العالمين. Dear Muslims, among the last surahs to be revealed to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is Surah At-Tawbah. And in fact, in the year of Hajj, the first Hajj, for the Muslims, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after opening Mecca, he didn't go. He appointed Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu to lead the Hajjaj. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam waited for the following year, as he is the absolute mercy that Allah sent. He wanted, he knows, everyone wanted to join him, so he wanted to give them a chance. So while Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was in Hajj, and he was about to start the salah, he heard, subhanAllah, the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is coming. And look at the Sahaba's connection with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As soon as he heard the footsteps, he thought maybe Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is here. So he stepped back. So it was Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu. So Sayyidina Ali said to him, Rasulullah did not send me as Amir, as a leader. You continue in your salah. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent me to read Surah At-Tawbah. Allah revealed for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam Surah At-Tawbah. And at the end of Surah At-Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, not to Muslims but to all humanity, to all the creation of Allah, Allah said, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Rabbi subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to us, speaking to all the creation. Indeed, a messenger among yourself has come to you. Azizun alayhi ma alaytum, it hurts him when you go astray. It upsets him when you disbelieve and you disobey. Harisun alaykum, he cares about all of you. But there is a special mercy for the mu'mineen. Bil mu'mineen ra'ufur rahim. But for all the mu'minis, he is the most merciful, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah used two attributes. Ar-Rahim is from the names of Allah, and Ar-Ra'uf is from the names of Allah. So Rasulullah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for all the believers. But before that, said Harisun alaykum, he cares about you all. And that's why Rabbi subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Anbiya, verse 107 said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We did not send you other than mercy to all the worlds. He did not say mercy to Muslims. He did not say mercy to humans. He said mercy to all the worlds. And Al-Alamin reminds you of the beginning of Surah Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. In some of the translation there is a mistake. They say we did not send you other than mercy to mankind. Absolutely wrong. So are you saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen? All the praise and all the thanks to Allah, the Lord of mankind or the Lord of the all worlds? And this rahmah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see it in every aspect of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life. But today, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, I want to concentrate in three things that we take with us. Because I can sit down and say I love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what did I do? That matters as well. The reflection of that love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because first, loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a favor that you are doing. You are loving the one who loved you more than you love yourself. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is iman. And he said that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of Anas radiallahu anhu, no one's iman can be completed unless he or she loves me more than their children, more than their wealth, and more than themselves. So may Allah fill our hearts with the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, there are three things that I wanted to speak about. Number one is, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in authentic narration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes dua. And he says in his dua, Allahumma ihdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lam. O Allah, guide my people. Verily, they don't know the truth. If you imagine this dua, for whom is he making sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the dua? For those who said a lot of awful things about him. For those who killed members of his family. For those who attempted to kill him. For those even who broke his teeth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was bleeding, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his helmet went into his cheek, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And yet, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, O Allah, guide my people. Verily, they don't know the truth. Al-Qadi Iyad, rahimahullah, says, And we said this before, but we have to repeat this because it didn't go into our long-term memory. It didn't change us. So you see this dua, three things. One is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making dua. Dua for whom? For those who had nothing for him other than hatred. For those who said things about him, if it was a fraction of it, if it was to be said to us, La ilaha illallah, Qiyamah will start. So number one, he makes dua for them. And number two, he related that to himself, Qawmi, my people. He doesn't distance himself from them. You know, even for us, even within each other, I'm a practicing Muslim, this is not practicing Muslim. Yes, ED, what are you doing in your practicing? So you are praying your fault? Few sinners? The Salihin always, the more Allah gives you, the more you will be humble, the more you will have mercy for others. You don't look down at people. And our Salihin, they used to say, لا تلومن المبتلى فيعافي الله المبتلى ويبتليك. Don't look down at people that are tested. Allah might grant them tawbah and success, Allah might test you. This journey of deen is only through humility. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is relating them to himself. He's saying, Qawmi, my people. But also he's making excuses for them. Saying, Ya Rabbi, they don't know the truth. If they know the truth, they want to follow you. So this, number one, I would say is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not face the hatred with hatred. Revenge, obsess. No, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us a different way, a way of rahmah, a way of forgiveness. He enters Makkah and all the people,
22 years. They've been saying things about him. They've been following him. They've been fighting against him. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them under his charge, he asked them, what do you think we're going to do to you? Even they know, they say, khair. Nothing comes from you other than khair. This is admission when they were fighting against the khair. They were rejecting the khair. They've been, subhanAllah, ungrateful, and yet he tells them, idhabu fa antum mutalaqa. Go, you are absolutely free. And this we need in our life. We need with our families, with our friends, at every aspect. If you are true follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the sunnah that you need to implement. Don't tell me I'm implementing the sunnah. If your heart is full of hatred, then there is no sunnah that you are following. This is number one. The second message I wanted to say as well is this deen, one of our purposes of our creation is prosperity, to seek good, to implement good, wherever we are to be a sources of good. So Allah said in the Quran, وَاسْتَعْمَرَكُمْ فِيهَا. Allah put you in charge of this earth to do good. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam changed everything in Medina. There is one hadith I would say, it would change the world. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ أَحْيَا أَرْضًا مَيِّتَةً فَهِيَ لَهُ. Whoever brings to life a dead land, that person will own it. Imagine that many neglected dead land. But when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ أَحْيَا أَرْضًا مَيِّتَةً. Whoever brings to life a neglected, a dead piece of land, that person will own it. Imagine what will happen to all the land that we have. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged people to work. When he saw that young man sitting down, he said, what's wrong with you? Why you are sitting here? You know, it wasn't a time of salah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, do you? He said, I'm in debt. He gave him dua, but also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, do you have another pair of clothes? He said, yes. He said, let's go to your house. Take the other pair of clothes, sell it in the market, buy a robe with that one, buy an axe, and work. We are ummah that wherever we go, we have to, subhanAllah, people they see the hard work, the building, this Medina. Do you know what Yathrib means? Yathrib means, subhanAllah, a land of, one of the meanings, a land of corruption. That's why, لا تثريب عليكم. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and he said, Al-Madina, Taiba, everything changed. And Sayyidina Zayd ibn Thabit said, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, أَضَاءَ مِنَا كُلُّ شَيْءٍ. Everything in Medina became new. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا خَيْرٌ مِنَا الْيَدِ السُّفْلَةِ. The hand that gives is better than the hand that takes. That meaning to work and to spread khair and to help. And the third message I wanted to give today, when we speak about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam transformed all the Sahaba. They were Bedouins, very harsh. They used to bury their daughters alive. And they became, subhanAllah, a source of rahmah and khair in every aspect of their life. And just take this hadith and think about it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking Sayyidina Anas, Iyad Sahabi, said, where is your brother? His little brother said, Ya Rasulullah, my brother is sad. He's crying. Why is he crying? Why is he sad? He said, he's a sparrow. His bird died. His bird died. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes all the way. He sits next to this child. He comforts this child. And he tells him, Ya Aba Umayr, ma fa'ala al-mughni. Keep giving him comfort until he forgets his sadness. Our ulama, when the ummah, when the ilm was Subhanallah, very much respected in the Ummah. They wrote many books just from this hadith.
So for us to be the source of comfort and rahmah, may Allah forgive our sins, purify our hearts, may Allah fulfill our hearts with the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, wa astaghfirullah, wa astaghfirullah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in authentic hadith, three things, if you have them, you will test the sweetness of Iman. You will test the sweetness of Iman. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever he say is wahi, a divine order. So may Allah make us from those who test the sweetness of Iman, ya Allah. Number one is, he said, to love Allah and His Messenger more than anyone else and more than anything else. Ya Rabbi, may I fill our hearts with His love. And this was very much evident with the Sahaba. Just imagine that woman when they were coming back from the battle, she said, ما فعل رسول الله؟ What happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They said, your husband died. She said, what happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Your son died. What happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Your brother died. They said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is fine. He said, Aruni, let me see him. Let me see him. And the hadith I'm giving is authentic. Just check it. And this is the answer for everyone says, sometimes some people say, just you obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that means you love him. La ya sidi. Obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is must, but love is more. Because this woman, she's not obeying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when she say, I don't care about anyone. Only one I care about is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because that is the deed. May Rabbi subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbi, fill our heart with His love, ya Rabbi. So number one, he said, to love Allah and His Messenger more than anyone and more than anything else. Number two, because love is one, you cannot divide. To love each other, to love whoever you love for the sake of Allah. Not for any business transaction, or because you want something from them, but because, no, just for the sake of Allah. Number three, to hate to go back to your life for Iman as you hate to be thrown to the hellfire. May Rabbi subhanahu wa ta'ala share our brothers and sisters in Palestine with His rahmah. May Allah end their suffering. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabb, ya Rabb, ya Rabb, ya Rabb, bless them with the dignity and the honor they deserve. May Rabbi pour sabra for them. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ya Rahman ya Rahim. كملا قلوبنا بمحبتك ومحبة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ونسألك يا رحمن يا رحيم أن تجعلنا ممن يقولون الحق وبيعملون. اللهم نزل شأبي برحمتك على أهلنا في فلسطين. اللهم نزل شأبي برحمتك على أهلنا في فلسطين. اللهم أفرغ عليهم صبرا. اللهم أفرغ عليهم صبرا. اللهم يا رب العالمين نزل على قلوبهم السكينة. تقبل يا رب الشهداء. اشفي المرضى والجرحى. ويا رب العالمين نسألك يا الله أن تكون لهم وتكون معهم يا كريم. يا رب يا الله اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما وتفرقنا متفرقا معصوما. لا تجعل فينا ولا منا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم بارك في هذا المسجد والقائمين عليه والزائرين والعباد واجعله منارة خير وهداية وصلاح ونور. اللهم نسألك يا الله يا الله يا الله زيادة في الدين وبركة في العمر وصحة في الجسد وتوبة قبل الموت وشهادة عند الموت ومغفرة بعد الموت وعفوا عند الحساب وأمانا من العذاب. ونسألك يا الله يا الله يا الله يا الله لا تحرمنا لذة النظر إلى وجهك الكريم يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. واسقنا يا الله من حوض الحبيب المصطفى والنبي المجتبى بيده الشريفة شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها. واغفر يا ربي لآبائنا وأمهاتنا وأجدادنا وأجداد أجدادنا ولمشايخنا ولمن علمنا حرفا واحدا من القرآن العظيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.